Hello everyone, my name is Raman. This is a position from a game that one of my students played, and it's why to move. As you look at this position, when you just take a look at it, it seems that Black Knight is trapped and it is about to be captured by King B2 next move, and followed by, so okay, that's one thing. And as you can notice that Black King is stopping this pawn, and White can simply go ahead and take the knight, and then he has all the time. But when you look at it deeply, as you can see that White's knight is also trapped. I mean, White's knight cannot go to the other side of the board easily. And if White King tries to stop the pawns, then the White knight, then the Black knight, which is trapped currently, becomes suddenly active. So that's one thing. And as you can see, the pawn majority on the king side, Black has a pawn majority on the king side, and he's threatening to play either h4 or f4. And when white captures it, he'll push the other pawn, and then he can create another post pawn. I mean, he can create a post pawn. So I mean, it's a kind of double-edged position, it looks. But There is a very simple way to win. So first thing is, this knight is not going anywhere. So we need not play immediately King B2 and follow it with King takes A2, and we need not do anything. So that's the one thing. And second thing is, we have to utilize our knight. Since our king cannot leave, we have to utilize some way or the other. We have to utilize our knight. So that's one thing. So I will show you two variations in which White is going to win, and you can analyze this position as much as you want, because it's a very rich position and a very instructive and interesting position. So here on d6 check, and after king e6, knight c7 check. Knight c7 check, and if takes with knight d5, and we are simply winning, because we are controlling the f4 square. So that's one thing to win. And for example, let's say king e5, we can go after this knight if wanted, because I don't know what you want to play. Maybe knight b4, or even knight takes c3, anything. Knight takes c3, at least taking a pawn. King takes c3, and I think we can take this, because we are going to stop this pawn with the even. If needed, we can just come back, or else we can even bring our knight back, and we can protect this pawn, and also we can control this, and we are about to queen, so that's winning. So that's one thing. So here, instead of d6 check, there is also another move, knight a7. Although we need to go to the king side. I mean, we need to go to the king side, but still we are going to the edge of the board. That's a very interesting geometry, I should say. And if h4, knight c8 check, king f6. So yeah, if knight c8, after knight c8 check, if king d7, then simple knight takes b6 check. After, let's say king d6, and simple g takes h4, and if f4, we can simply bring the king back, and this is winning. So I mean, let's not complicate the position. So after knight here, check if king f6. I mean, in that variation again, White is winning. You can check it out. King after king f6, knight d6 check, and king e5, knight takes f5, king takes f5, and after g takes h4, and we are going to collect the knight and push. We are having two post pawns, and the king cannot capture both the pawns. So that's the reason it's winning for White. So yeah, very interesting position, and very interesting, very rich position. And you have to come up with any of these ideas. And so that's all, guys. That's all in this video. I hope you like this video. So please subscribe to my channel for more videos. Please comment what you want to see in my next coming videos. Like, you want to see my games, you want to see some instructional videos, you want to see some endgame videos like this, or some instructional videos like where I showed you like the games of some games, some interesting positions, and I explain this or something like that. So please comment, and definitely I'll post those videos. So yeah, thank you for watching. Please subscribe to my channel for more videos, and have a good day. Bye.